What's going on, my friend? A few days ago, I asked you the questions you'd love to see me answer. And this was one of the most popular questions: how to eat clean without being vegan or vegetarian. And I totally get it because I love meat too. So in this video, I'm going to share with you some of the foods that you can add to your diet to maintain optimal health and also lose weight if that is your goal. Now, these foods are based off my program, the 6 weeks weight loss challenge, which has been very successful. I've run this challenge for more than a year, and during this period, I've had over 1,000 people go through it and lose weight. So what I'm going to share with you here is already proven. And the first food category we are going to look into is carbohydrates. I choose carbohydrates first because they are very controversial. Many people believe that carbs are bad for weight loss. And that is true if you're eating processed carbs. But there are healthy carbs that can help you lose weight and maintain optimal health. So the first carb is sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes are good for weight loss because they are low in calories, rich in fiber, and rich in nutrients. So eat them. And the best way to cook them is by boiling them. You can also eat pumpkins or yams or chia seeds. Now, with chia seeds, the best way to eat chia seeds, especially if you're trying to control hunger, is to add them, soak them in water for like 2 hours and then drink the water. Alternatively, you can soak them in yogurt, plain yogurt or Greek yogurt. Soak them overnight. That way you'll be able to control hunger and also get your carbs. The other food is brown rice. So these are a few carbohydrates that you can add to your diet. Now, let's move on to protein, which actually answers this question because there are animal protein and plant proteins. So let's start with the animal protein. So with animal protein, you can eat things like fish. Fish is very good because it not only has protein, it also has omega-3s, which are good for fighting inflammation. As you may know, inflammation has been linked to conditions such as cancer, diabetes, heart disease, and many other diseases. So adding fish to your diet will definitely improve your health. The next food you can eat here is chicken. Now here you eat free-range chicken because it is healthier. And at the same time, you can eat skinless chicken if you're trying to lose weight, because skin has a lot of calories, a lot of fat and a lot of calories. So steer clear of chicken that has skin if you're trying to lose weight. The other type of animal protein here you can eat is eggs. Now, if you're looking for an affordable diet, this is the best way to go about it. Eat eggs, boiled eggs, instead of just frying them, which will add calories because of the oil. Another type of animal protein you can eat is beef. Now, it depends on which part of the world you live. If you live in a place like Kenya, you don't have to worry about whether the meat is grass-fed or not, because all meat here is grass-fed. But if you live in maybe in America, for example, you need to buy grass-fed meat. Grass-fed meat. So these are a few types of meat that you can add to your diet. Obviously, when you're cooking this type of meat, make sure that you're using minimal oil. At the same time, avoid fatty cuts, meat that has a lot of fat. So this is mostly for beef. Eat lean beef. It's ideal for weight loss. Now, for plant protein, you can eat things like You can eat lentils, beans, peas, and many other types of plant protein. If you do a quick Google search, you'll find plenty of plant protein that you can add to your diet. The other type of food we are going to address is vegetables. Veggies. Now, with vegetables, you don't have to be choosy. You can eat any type of vegetable, because vegetables are the food that you have to eat Whether your goal is to lose weight, maintain optimal health, you can't avoid vegetables because they have lots of nutrients and they are also filling, meaning that you can eat lots of vegetables without excess calories. And that's what you want, especially when you're trying to lose weight. So eat all type of vegetables, things like spinach, kale, broccoli, any type of vegetable. Here we can go on and on and on. Cabbage. Now, the only reason you would be choosy when it comes to vegetables is, for instance, if you have ulcers, you might want to avoid things like kale because they are acidic. Or if you have maybe thyroid issues, you might want to avoid certain types of vegetables. But unless you have any of these conditions, eat all types of vegetables. Now, the final food category we are going to discuss is fats, healthy fats. Fats are vital for optimal health because, for one, they contain lots of nutrients that are not only good for your body, but also good for your brain. So, actually, studies show that increasing your fat intake can help combat conditions like depression. So, it's very important you make sure that you eat enough fats. But with fats, you have to be careful because of the calories. 1 gram of fat has 9 calories. Compare that to 4 calories you'll find in a gram of protein. So that's a big difference. Now with fats, you want to maximize on 2 types of fats. Or 3 types, I mean. So we have seeds such as pumpkin seeds, or flax seeds. Then the other category to maximize on is nuts. Nuts such as peanuts, almonds, and so on. Then the other category of foods here is, not really a category but a food, is avocado. Avocado is good for weight loss because of the many factors that are also in these foods. It has fiber, it has lots of nutrients, but unlike most of these foods here, avocado is very high in calories. So eat it in moderation. And this applies to all healthy fats. Eat them in moderation because of the high calorie content. So basically that is it. These are some of the foods that you can eat to be able to eat clean without being a vegan or a vegetarian. And these foods will help you maintain optimal health. If you're looking for a healthier skin or just more energy, these are foods to add to your diet. Now, if you need a complete guide on how to eat and the exercises to do, join the 6 weeks weight loss challenge. Because in this challenge, I will guide you every step of the way. I'll show you what to eat in every meal, breakfast, lunch, and dinner for 6 weeks. And you will learn a lot throughout the 6 weeks. So don't just leave it here. Come join the challenge and I'll guide you every step of the way. That's all from me today. See you in the next video. And remember to share the video with your friends and subscribe to my channel if you haven't.